Donald Trump and Joe Biden face off in their first debate Tuesday night in Cleveland. CBS News will, of course, bring it to you live. But first, a preview from John Dickerson.
In 1961, Walter Cronkite asked former President Dwight Eisenhower whether a sitting president should participate in campaign debates.
I can't think of anything that's worse. Any man that is incumbent, as an incumbent, has to stick to the facts. He's a responsible man, debating with someone who, if he chooses, can be irresponsible.
President Trump does not share Ike's concern about sticking to the facts. The opposite. He has so boosted the fact-checking industry, it counts as government stimulus. Of course, Eisenhower didn't only stick to the facts. In 1960, when an American spy plane was shot down over the Soviet Union, Ike denied that the U.S. was spying. When the Soviets produced a living U.S. pilot, President Eisenhower had to admit he had not told the truth, but explained that he was trying to protect U.S. national security. A president has an obligation to honesty and to secrecy. Sometimes those obligations clash. When they do, a president has a lonely choice about which is more important. That is just one of the many burdens of the presidency, for which debates are a part of the job interview. Who do Americans trust to make the toughest decisions with imperfect information day after day, often in secret? During the debate, we should ask, which candidate has the character, temperament, and vision to make the right call? If you learned about the obligations of the presidency only from the moments that make presidential debate history, you wouldn't know what kind of job it was.
Typically, is against such a proposal.
There you go again.
He didn't pay any federal income tax. So
that makes
if he's
smart.
Paid zero, that means zero.
The presidency is about big challenges and having the skills to manage surprises that may never even come up at the debates. In 2000, Al Gore and George W. Bush faced off three times. The word terrorism was only uttered once and nearly in passing. The issue, though, would dominate the two terms of the Bush presidency. Debates encourage us to obsess over the momentary, gaffes, the political spat of the day, or topics that are better handled by Congress. But we should remember the real weight of the office, which resembles the debate stage in one important way. A president must stand alone and do the right thing when the whole world is watching.
When, where, and how to cast your ballot? Planning to vote by mail? Go online for state-by-state instructions and download the CBS News app.